to the drum. In the neon lights. Yeah. Well, I heard the thunder, I can feel the rain. Yeah. It's the same religion, it's a different name. Won't you follow me into the jungle?
Hallway on the floor above. You need a line upstairs. No water.
Mayday, mayday, mayday! Let it do seven, mayday!
You gotta get a hole in the roof before the steel blows down on everybody! Division 7 to the mayday message. Ken, who's the mayday?
It's a member from 27th Bronx. He's out of here. Oh, mask has been lowered to him.
What's
happening to
40? How you making out your line?
Cutters on the roof! You're gonna need to send the rope over the side! Roof team, send the rope over the side! To the 2-4 side of the building!
Vision 7-2-1, ladder 5-9, finish truck, roof on the rope! We got guys out the rear window, okay? Mayday, mayday, 5-6, stand down, fellas!
Put your pumps in your
room. Mayday, mayday, 2 firemen from the top floor in the rear. We need them.
On the morning of January 23rd, 2005, six New York City firefighters jumped out of 4 four-story windows of a tenement in the Bronx, falling 50 feet to the pavement. Two of them died from their injuries, another 4 barely survived, sustaining massive injuries of their own that left several of them in the hospital for months and effectively ended their careers. What became known as Black Sunday now serves as a reminder of how dangerous our job can be. Training is a very large and important part of the job. The crew of Station 1 has the added task of training 2 probationary firemen that are currently assigned to downtown.
Sensei, cause he's the one that taught me. Bow down, not a master chef. Yo, anything you need, I can blast your rock. Be proud, hold the phone. I can never have enough, but you're on the run. And the blade's so sharp, I can cut your hand. My arm like a tree drawn Superman.
There is an inherent risk with firefighting that we've all come to accept as part of our job. It is our duty to train and continue to improve ourselves to help reduce that risk so each of us can go home at the end of the shift.
I am Garrett Olegi, son of Todd Olegi, Captain Todd Olegi, grandson of Assistant Chief Ronald Olegi. I'm a volunteer fireman out of Cattle Parish Fire District 6. I've been there for about 3 years. Today we trained on firefighter survival training. It was quite an experience for me since it was the 4th or 5th time I've worn a pack. I had a bunch of haberdasher given gear.
You lay down, O'Leggy, lay down. Okay.
Adam Jones, anchor point.
Okay, y'all start. And just turn a circle. There you go.
Yeah, I mean, if you wanted to become a volunteer like myself, you know, you could do it. You really could. You just got to put the time and the effort in. Because I know I have every learning disability under the sun plus asthma. And I'm, you know, I don't want to say one of the best, but I'm good at what I know to do out here in this field.
My name's Adam Richardson. I'm a firefighter EMT here in Shreveport. I'm currently assigned to Engine 1 right now. I've been on for about 9 months now. This is my first rookie rotation. All right, training today, we did evacuation procedures. It's not something that we think about a lot of times when we go into a smoky environment and think about getting out. A lot of times people just think that you can just go in, come right out. Well, today we did something where we had to find our way out in an emergency situation to where we had to find the hose, get ourselves out. We had to go over and under obstacles. We were completely blacked out on our face pieces. We had to find the hose, come out with the hose, back to the fire truck, and it's very practical to do it because, like I was saying, a lot of people don't think about when we go in and we get blacked out and you can't see nothing. You know, the only thing you got is your equipment. And if you don't know your equipment, you know, if you don't know that and you don't practice with it often, a lot of people, they tend to forget how to use it. And so if you practice with it, that's what helps you.
My name is Joseph Beard, rank of firefighter right now at Shreveport Fire. And I've been here since November on the line. I've been in the fire service for about 6 years now. No, sorry, 8 years. 8 years now. Well, last night pretty much what we did was originally we started off as a standard response. Engine company came in, rescue truck came in after that, battalion company, medic unit, what we would normally send to a house fire. During the simulation, we portrayed a downed firefighter with a Mayday call. When this happens, downed firefighter, whoever he's with, they page out a Mayday call. All radio traffic on that channel stops except for that firefighter and the battalion chief. In that case, that's when the RIT team, which is what I was on with the rescue truck, we go in at that moment and we go to locate the downed firefighter. Oh, training is one of the most important things you can find. I mean, it's, you know, they always say it's muscle memory. I mean, that's a very true fact. Not only are you thinking in that case, sometimes you don't even have time to think. You just have to do what you're trained to do. When they say your training takes over, that's as true of words as you can find. I mean, they drill this stuff in your head over and over and over again. You're bunkering out and left, right-handed search patterns, and that's more or less what you're trained to do. You can't sit back and think, okay, well, what am I going to do in this situation? What am I going to do in that situation? Because that takes too long. You have to react as fast as you see it, and that's when your training does take over. So in that case, when a downed firefighter comes across, we don't have time to think, okay, well, what's step A, what's step B? It needs to be quick. And that's, like I said, that's where your training comes in. And you do muscle memory with that.
My name's Donald Ferguson. I'm captain on Battalion 1, safety officer. When we're on the fire scene, the last thing that any firefighter ever wants to hear is Mayday, Mayday, Mayday. We're not there to rescue each other. We're called to help people, the community, the citizens. And that's what we focus on. But if it ever were to happen, if a firefighter were to ever get trapped or lost, injured, we want to be prepared to do everything within our ability to respond accordingly to be able to rescue that firefighter or those firefighters, however many it may be that are trapped. So I want to encourage all of you to study our Mayday policy, know it backwards and forwards, from battalion chiefs, ask your captains, train with your crews, know what you're supposed to do. So if the situation ever arises, we're not wondering, what do we do? How will I get out of this? Are they coming for me?